Okay, so things got off to a bit of a rocky start in the world of Austin Cloud, but we're here. That is the house where they filmed Scream. That's Stu Mocker's house. But first, a little bit of a brief story time, because I did not film any of it. I did take some pictures. Carlos got into an accident, so I was driving, and I was about an hour early for 10:30's showing. And so I decided to try to go up to Point Reyes. And on the way up to Point Reyes, Carlos slid and got stuck in a bunch of mud. And I was there for a while. I had someone pick me up and drove me to the town. And then I made some phone calls, but nothing really worked. And we lost reception. There's no reception in the area that I was in. But in any case, though, I went back to the car. We tried getting it out ourselves. We tried putting sticks under the tires, some cardboard under the tires, whatever would work. Nothing ended up working. Until eventually, this truck pulled up with two guys, and they were like, "You can't park here." And they pulled out a strap, attached it to the bumper of Carlos, which was bare at the time, and then pulled me out. And, yeah, so luckily, too, I was able to refix the bumper to Carlos as well. So right now, I'm at 85 millimeters on my brand new 85 1.4, but you can kind of see the house here looks really nice. I'm going to go ahead and switch to 17 to 40 in a second.
When he sits up and says "F you, Mindy," and she's standing over there, so it's in this room that that happens. It's pretty cool. So we're going to continue the tour back here into a room that was never shown in the original film. Ghost face mask when she stabs Billy in the chest. Little fun fact, in case you didn't know, Sydney actually does stab him. She actually hit his skin. And it actually made it into that Richie is hiding in when Nev shoots through the door. And then Ghostface appears out of this room, although in Scream 5 it's not double doors, it's just a single door. And then they flip over the side of the rail here. And something I like to add, because I find it interesting, if you peek over the side here, you'll see how high this is. And if you flipped over this and landed on your back, I don't think you'd be getting up. But it's original. And also, after she slams the door into Ghostface, she runs through a door that was right there that is no longer there. I have no idea why they covered it up, but it leads to another part of the house that we'll get to in just a little bit. Okay? Follow me this way. We'll continue on. This is where Billy and Sydney did their thing. And as you can see in this picture here, the bed was positioned in the same exact spot. Right where you're standing, Lane, is right where Billy put his shoes on. Sydney was sitting on the edge of the bed right here. Pretty awesome. Something I find pretty interesting, in the entire scene before Ghostface appears, the bathroom door back there is always closed, but then after Ghostface appears, it's open, which I find pretty interesting. I'm not really sure why they did that. They probably didn't anticipate I would be picking it apart and doing these tours, but that's a bathroom. So it doesn't really make sense for Stu to be hiding in that bathroom the entire time. But anyway, there's also something else that's interesting. There's many camera angles in the original film that face this direction, you can see all of this part of the room, but you never get to see that part of it. And it was always there. Pretty interesting. And I first saw Scream when I was 10 years old, and I've seen it so many times, and I've always wondered, how did Ghostface cut her off down there after he got locked out of the room over there? And you're about to find out right now, because there's two entrances to this room. So follow me back down the stairs and we'll continue on. Having a horror film, Jamie was standing right where you're standing. Ooh. When he gave the rules. Pretty cool. It was decorated, obviously, very differently. When they were filming the movie, it was decorated more like a living room. All right, so this is the kitchen. By far, most people's favorite room of this house, including mine. There's a lot of cool stuff to talk about in here. And I will begin with the stovetop. So, the stovetop is original. You can see it very clearly in multiple scenes in Scream. I think the best time you can see it is when Tatum and Sydney first arrive at the party. All the detail up here on this, they recreated all of it for Scream 5, and I've not been able to see a single difference in this. However, with the stovetop, this thing is an antique. It's incredibly old and incredibly rare and valuable. So I think they just didn't even bother trying to recreate that for Scream 5, so it's just a regular looking stove. However, the really cool...
Baby Ghostface! Adolescent Ghostface!
Alright, so this should look a little familiar. This area of the house, right? Decorated much differently. Back in Scream, it was much darker. It looked more like an attic, in my opinion. And earlier I mentioned that there was a door that was blocked off, and it was in the corner over there. That's the door that Sydney ran through and then blocked it with a surfboard to stop Ghostface from following her down. And Nev Campbell, Sydney, ran down right here over to those windows over there. And that's where you can see that wide shot of her outside of the house, and she's screaming for help. And by then in the movie, it's deserted out there. There's nobody here. So then she runs over here and actually does climb out this window. And Nev Campbell actually did climb out this window. So I'm going to get out of the way. And if you guys want to just kind of come stick your head out and check it out. So this is the garage. This is where Tatum met her demise, and she figured out that she's not the size of a small dog. There was a doggy door right there. And if you turn around and look at Ghostface, you see a familiar sight. Directly related to the house, but if you kind of just follow me this way, it's actually not really raining too bad right now. It's just kind of misting. You don't have to come out if you don't want to, just this way. So right on the road right there is where Dewey and Gale were walking up when they were going to investigate the car. Remember? And you're led to believe in the movie that they're walking away from the house, but they weren't. They were walking towards the house, and they were right there where those trees are. That's where David Arquette and Courtney Cox jumped off the road, and the speeding car with the teenagers actually went through the gate right there, up into the hill right there. Pretty cool? Yes. Yes, the window. We talked about the window when I brought him up there. So before we start talking about all the goodies, I want to introduce our Ghostface actor here.
Oh, hey.
Franco Caramellino.
Okay, I can breathe now.
Okay, so we can step back aside.
Okay, so the tour is officially over. I bought myself one of the posters that they made here, and some cheese and some butter for some steaks. But it was really a fun tour. It was a really great time. It's a really beautiful house, as you can see behind me here. Super cool. And they had a guy dressed up as Ghostface. I'll go ahead and try to put his Instagram in the thing here, but it was still super cool. I can't believe it. That was a lot of fun. And what a day. The car skids off. Carlos here. Super dirty and gross from being in mud for about 2 hours, and he still made it. But yeah, that was a lot of fun. As always, go ahead, subscribe to Austin and Stacy on YouTube, and of course this channel here. Leave a like if you're a Scream fan. What's your favorite kill from any of the Scream movies? I'm not gonna spoil my favorite because it's in Scream 6, but I'm gonna go ahead and take some more pictures of the house. As you can see, it's still gorgeous. So we're gonna go do that. Peace, goodbye.